Let f and g be the functions f of x 5 minus x minus 2x squared, g of x is 1 minus 3x. I have to draw both these diagrams, okay? So will somebody be so kind as to give me the points on this one? Ron, you should have it done for homework, so you should be able to tell me what points are on the graph. Minus 3 minus 10, yeah. Minus 2 minus 1, yeah. Minus 1 and 4, yeah. 0, 5, yeah. 1, 2. 2 minus 5, yeah. 3 minus 16, okay. Now, there's also another graph in there as well. It's the straight line, so can I give you the values for the straight line? Keen, go again.
2 minus
3, 10. Minus 3, 10, yeah. Minus 2 minus 5, yeah, and 3 minus 8. Okay. Now, what I'm going to have to do next, I'm going to have to draw this, okay? So, we put them into our table function on our calculator, and we've got was all these points here, okay? So, just got to put them down here. There we go. Okay. I have to go as far down as 26. Sorry, I have to go as low as minus 16 and as high as what? 10. So I have to go 10 all the way down to minus 16. So you're going to need 26 blocks to make this work. So let's all have 26 blocks on the board here. Okay, let's find out. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 8. 24, 26. Perfect. So that's it. So I'll count down. So 10, 8, 6, 4, 2, 0, minus 2, minus 4, 6, 6, 10, 12, 14, and finally minus 16. Okay, and put a line in here. Stretch out the x-axis a wee bit, so you get 1, 2, and 3. Stretch out the y-axis a bit, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3. Put in your points, so what do we get here? Minus 10. It's there. Minus 2, minus 1. It's actually here. Minus 1, 4. There. 0, 5, 1, 2, 2 minus 5, yeah, now, and 3 minus 16. Now guys, I'm a bit unsure about how it turns at the top. Do you guys see that? I'm a bit unsure as to how that's going to turn. Do you ever see the top part? Can anybody tell me a trick for finding more points? Yeah? Do the 0.5 on the scale, okay, and that will tell me some more. Alright guys, so what I'm going to do here is I'm going to find out some extra points for this graph, okay, so what is it? It's 5 minus x squared, and we're going from, let's say I'll just do, minus 3 to plus 3, I'll do steps of 0.5. Now I'm interested in the highest peak here. 1.5, there we are. 0.5 is 5 and a quarter, so I can make this 5 and a quarter up here. So 0.5 is here, so 0.5 is here, so that's 5 and a quarter, so it's just a tiny bit above 5. Okay, that might make things a bit easier. In fact, it makes things worse. What am I looking at here? Oh, minus 0.5, excuse me. Minus 0.5 is 5. Then I can go for a plus 0.5. A plus 0.5 will give me 4.25, so just above the just above the 4. There we go. Easy to draw now, isn't it? I have those extra points I can use. So, 1, just put those go up here, down. There we go. Okay. Excellent. Very easy to do. Let's just do the beginning and end. So we have a 3 minus 8, which is down here. And then we also have, what's it, -3, 10. Here. That, to me, would mean that we're going to have a green line. There's it there. Great. Do they have any points in common? What 2 points do they have in common? Oh, yeah, not -3, 10. Oh, there, that's a sorry, I thought. -1, 4, yeah. What's the other one? I think it's 2 minus 5. And actually, as it turns out, I forgot to draw the black line to the end, didn't I? I forgot to finish it off. Alright guys, that's my diagram. Let's begin. Okay. Find the values for which they're equal. When are they equal? X equals -1 and X equals 2. Everybody right with that? The 2 points where the 2 points are the same. Find the coordinates of the points of intersection. Well, I think one of them is -1, 4, and the other one is 2, -5. Okay, you guys? When is the y value of the line bigger than the y value of the curve? Where? Which one's higher, curve or the line? The line is above the curve. Agree with that? So when does it stop? Stops at x equals -1. But any number before that, it's bigger than it, isn't it? It has a higher y value. So what do we say? X less than or equal to -1. Everybody okay with that? Now, explain how solving this equation verifies your answer. To part 2. Okay. What is f of x again? F of x is what, guys? 5 minus x minus 2x squared. Is everybody happy that's f of x? Alright, guys. Look at this. What's g of x? 1 minus 3x. Alright. So, what happens now? Move it all over one side and we get 2x squared. What's it? -2x. No. Move all of them to the left or to the right now. Pretty sure I'm on point. -4. Okay, we're cool with that. D equals 0 can go on equal either side, can't it? So I'm quite lazy, I'll just do that. And then what do I do next? Divide by 2. There you go. When you try to solve this algebraically, you put the two formulas equal to each other, and you end up getting the same formula. Does that make sense? So when you put f of x equal to g of x, you put the two formulas into each other, and you can rearrange the two of those formulas into this quadratic equation. This quadratic equation is x minus 2 and x plus 1 equals 0. This means x equals minus 1. That belongs to that point up there. And the other one is x equals 2, which oddly enough belongs to that point there. Alright. To do it algebraically, just put the two formulas equal to each other. So, move on. We'll try a similar one, okay? We'll try 11. We'll see if we can get the flow a bit better now, okay? We'll try again. So, is everybody happy with the first part? Draw the diagram. Everyone knows how to draw the diagram? Okay, so, what we're going to do here is, step one is to put these two functions into your calculator, then draw out the graph. Did everybody roughly get an N-shaped function for the curve? Like so. And then a line, y equals x minus 4. Everybody cool with that? So we have our graph here and we've drawn it, okay? So all's good. Now, next thing. So done. Find the maximum value of f. Where is it at its peak? So what do you think? Now, if you weren't sure from your calculator, because most of you are saying, look, that says 3 plus 2x, and then it's minus 2x squared, and you're saying starts at, what's it, minus 3, ends at 4, step 1 even. Now, you look down, and you think the peak is, most of you will think the peak is 1, 3. What's a 0, 3, and 1, 3? Does that make sense? Now, 0, 3 and 1, 3 are located here. That's 0, 3 right there. The blue one is 0, 3. The green one is 1, 3. That goes straight across. That's no good. This means the peak must be directly in the middle at 0.5. Back to the calculator again, really quickly. Equals start, finish, step 0.5. Go again, and then you can see that the actual peak is 3.5. This would imply that the maximum is 0.5 and 3.5. The maximum value means the y value. So the answer is simply 3.5. The maximum point would be both and combined. Both answers. Is that alright? Any questions thus far? Draw your diagram. Yeah. Now, next thing. Find the values from which f of x equals g of x, correct one decimal place. Okay. Now, it does tell us to use the graph, doesn't it? It really tells us to use the graph. Okay. So here's what you can do. So, to use the graph, and it also says use your graphs. Okay, so where do they equal? So, we're going for this point here in red, this point here in red, then you draw a line going straight up. And where does it hit the axis? What do you reckon that is, and what do you reckon this is? I'd say 2.2, and what do you think the other one is? Minus 1.6, I'd say. Everybody okay with that? If you're roughly in that range, you're good. So this is x equal to minus 1.6, x also equal to 2.2. That's the x values for which the line and the curve have the same point. Good? Okay, next part. The range of values for which the f function has a bigger y value than the g function. Or essentially, when is the curve bigger than or equal to the line? When is it higher up on the y-axis? Anybody tell me where it starts? What point is this? Starts at 1.6 or 1.7. Where does it end? Point two. Essentially what I'm saying is that the curve which is in yellow, the curve that's in yellow is higher on the y-axis than the line that's in blue. Everybody happy with that? So how do I write that in maths form using inequality signs? Anybody care to tell me? X has to be bigger than minus 1.6. Agree with that? All the x values in this region, where are they? All the x values are bigger than minus 1. Agree with that? And all the x values are smaller than 2.2. Each one is, if you go to the top of the question, you can see that that has an x squared in it. Or this has got an x squared in it. Now, this is the part that we were using in answer in part 3. We found out the values for x in which the intercept. Everybody remember doing that? We found out this point here is minus 1.6, x equals minus 1.6. No bother. This point here we thought was around 2.2. Is that okay? Now, basically, if you look at part 3. What does this part stand for? That's the curve, and g of x is the line. When does the curve equal the line? What's the formula for the curve again? formula for curve is 3 plus 2x minus 2x squared. It has to equal the line, x minus 4. Okay, I think that's what it is. Okay, move it all over one side. 2x squared. What's it? X, take away 2x minus 1x. 3. Minus 4 minus 3 is minus 7. Put the equal to 0 over the other side. How did I know this is going to be a minus b formula? Anybody tell me how I knew it was going to be a minus b formula? Look at these answers. What do you know about them? That's it. So it's going to be a minus b formula all day long. So, to verify the algebraically, you put the formula for the curve equal to the formula for the line. And solve the x values, it should tell you the two x values that they're equal for. If I don't get near minus 1.6 and near 2.2, I've gone extremely wrong. So check this out. Okay, so the minus b formula, this is probably for your exam. Everybody take out the calculator. Okay, so a is 2, b is minus 1. 7. So 1 plus or minus the square root of b squared. Error. Ow. Anybody else get a maths error?
Where did you get the maths error from?
Yes. Oh, minus 4 by the A, so it's 2, sorry guys. So this should be a 2. It's 4AC, not 4. Or BC. You need a krill. No. 2.14. That's the answer we got as 2.2. And then the other one. Put the minus in here and we're hoping for somewhere around 1.6. Yeah, so that's pretty accurate, wasn't it? Minus 1.64 if it's 2 decimal places. Everybody happy enough with that? Okay. Move on to another one. Okay. 14, okay. Once again, guys, I'm going to use my function to draw these, okay? Alright, guys, so in question 14, you put the two formulas into your calculator and you draw the two graphs. So when you see fx equals 4x plus 5, you should all know that means if you were to use mx plus c, where does it intercept the x-axis? Or the y-axis, sorry. Where does it intercept the y-axis? 0, 5. When x is 0, y must be 5. What type of slope should I have? Slope of 4, as it turns out. Look, that's 1 across, oddly enough. See the way it goes from 0 to 1? And how much up would it be? 4 up. So what's the slope of the graph again? Slope is 4. C-intercept is 5. Okay. Cool. Next thing. We did the equation of f of x. So, Ben, in this case, f of x is actually the curve. F is the curve. And g is the... Oh, sorry. F is the line. And g is the curve. That's what we're talking about earlier. Okay. Now, when does f of x equal g of x? What 2 points? What do we reckon? Minus 1, 1, and 1, 9. Everybody kill with that? And it only wants the x value, so it's x equals minus 1 and x equals plus 1. Now, find the range of values for which, what's this one again? What's f in this question? Well, find when the line is bigger than or equal to the curve. Okay, line bigger than curve. There's the line. Here's the curve. So what do you reckon? When is the blue above the yellow? Anybody? What do you write down? Starts at? Okay. Do your calculator. Starts at? At x equals minus 1. When does it end? Ends at x equals 1. What do you reckon? How do you write down an inequality constant? X has to be bigger than or equal to minus 1, which is minus 1 less than or equal to x. X also has to be smaller than or equal to 1. Then what do? Merge them. There's my answer. That's my answer for part 2. We're good with that? Now what about the next part? When is the line smaller than the curve? When is the line smaller than the curve? Well, I would argue that if I highlight this part of the curve here, the curve is in yellow. Would everybody agree the curve is in yellow? What's underneath it? The line is going underneath it. In fact, the line is going all the way down here. The line is definitely underneath the curve there, and where else? Up here as well, isn't it? The curve continues to be above the line. So what are those two values? X bigger than or equal to 1, or X smaller than or equal to minus 1. Alright, David, what questions did I do today?